South Carolina Department of Natural Resources established Seabird Sanctuaries in 2006 to protect highly vulnerable coastal bird species such as shorebirds and seabirds. South Carolina Department of Natural Resources owns and manages several seabird sanctuaries along the coast, including Crab Bank, Deveaux Bank, and Bird Key-Stono. The seabird sanctuaries are undeveloped ephemeral islands which often shift in shape and size with wave action and storms. Some vegetation is present, and predators such as raccoon and coyote are absent. Shorebirds are a group of birds that frequent the coast and shoreline. They forage on mudflats and in the sand for prey items. They are solitary nesters and will defend their territory. Seabirds, on the other hand, are colonial nesters and will feed on small fish by diving for their food in the water. Both rely on coastal environment for survival.
Seabird and shorebird populations have declined by 70% in the last 40 to 60 years. As a result, nearly three-fourths of South Carolina's coastal birds are listed at the high or highest level of conservation concern. These birds have declined in part due to loss of coastal habitat. One conservation strategy adopted by the South Carolina Department of Natural Resources is to provide places like the seabird sanctuaries for these birds to nest, rear young, and rest without disturbance. South Carolina's seabird sanctuaries provide a safe nesting site in the spring and summertime for about 20 species of water birds. One of these is the brown pelican, which was once driven near extinction due to pollutants, but has since made a remarkable comeback. Each year, these iconic seabirds will return to the remote sanctuaries to find a mate and make a nest using a mix of sticks, marsh grass, and wrack. They will incubate 3 eggs for a month. Chicks hatch without feathers and rely on their parents for food and protection. It takes roughly 3 months for a chick to learn how to fly and be independent. In a given year, there can be up to 5,000 pairs of nesting brown pelicans on the South Carolina Department of Natural Resources seabird sanctuaries, which is approximately 40% of all the nesting brown pelicans on the East Coast. Deveaux Bank and Bird Key-Stono interchangeably host the single largest brown pelican colony on the Atlantic coast of the U.S.
Black skimmers also rely on the safe habitat the sanctuaries provide to nest and raise their young. The unmistakable orange and black bill facilitates the black skimmer's unique feeding strategy of dropping the lower bill in the water and snapping it shut once they feel a fish. Black skimmers are species of highest conservation concern in South Carolina. In some years, 25% of all nesting black skimmers on the East Coast will occur in South Carolina, primarily on our seabird sanctuaries. Other notable species using these islands are royal and sandwich terns, with large colonies of 13,000 nests each year in South Carolina.
Colonial nesting behavior of these birds using these sites makes them very susceptible to disturbance. They're densely packed into breeding sites, and a single disturbance from people or dogs can result in destruction, abandonment, and failure of entire nesting colonies. Disturbance can also cause death and abandonment of eggs and chicks of solitary nesting shorebirds through exposure to heat and predators. The primary goal of these sites is to provide and protect habitat without disturbance to nesting, roosting, and feeding seabirds, shorebirds, and wading birds. Thus, all seabird sanctuaries are closed to all landing between March 15th and October 15th, with the exception of Deveaux Bank, which has designated open areas. And Tompkins Island is closed year-round. Dogs, camping, motorized vehicles, as well as bicycles are not allowed at any of these sites at any time. Between October 16th and March 14th, access is restricted to the intertidal zone only.
Additionally, these sandy islands provide safe areas for wintering and migrating shorebirds to rest and refuel. Many shorebird species, such as the federally threatened red knot, undertake hemispheric migrations and rely on specific habitats and food resources to survive. South Carolina hosts one of the largest flocks of these small shorebirds. Recently, up to 8,000 have been observed and monitored in South Carolina. They use seabird sanctuaries on their springtime migration. Red knots nest in the Arctic and winter as far as the southern tip of South America, a journey of 18,000 miles a year.
The piping plover is a federally listed shorebird that spends winters on various seabird sanctuaries in South Carolina. They can be found foraging by the water's edge at low tide. Sometimes they'll tap their foot on the sand to bring small worms and other soft-bodied animals up to the surface where they can more easily eat them.
At night, tens of thousands of birds will head to these remote islands for a safe space to sleep and rest. Notably, Deveaux Bank hosts the world's largest known concentration of a rare curlew species called the whimbrel. Roughly 20,000 gather on the sandbar at night during their springtime migration.
SCDNR biologists visit each site during the nesting season to document the species that are nesting, the number of nests, and the success or failure of these colonies. Surveys are conducted using the latest techniques that are least intrusive to the birds. Additionally, staff ensure proper signage indicating closures, and regularly monitor to contribute to long-term data collection of numbers and species observed at these sites.
South Carolina coast geography is part of the reason for its abundance of wildlife, but equally important is the history of conservation and commitment by its citizens to preserve wild places. Seabird sanctuaries in South Carolina are crucial. Over the last 10 years, approximately 90% of South Carolina's seabird nesting has occurred on these seabird sanctuary islands. These places are an invaluable conservation tool which supports the nesting success of most of our seabirds and shorebirds.